Hey everybody, how's it going? I'm Paul, I'm with the Dicey Review. And today we're going to learn how to play the 4-8 player game Subtext, being released by Stronghold Games in the US. Subtext comes with all of the components that you see here, including one game board, 5 number cards, 115 word cards, player components in the 8 different player colors, 1 block of paper, 8 pencils, and 8 plastic standees. Before playing your first game, make sure and put the player figures in the plastic standees. Next, place the game board in the center of the table. Then, shuffle all of the word cards and create a face-down deck next to the game board. Then, choose a number card and place that card on its indicated space at the top of the game board. This number card will indicate the difficulty of the words being used during the game. In your first game, it's recommended to use the number 1 card. Next, each player will need to take the player figure of their favorite color, a pencil, and a few sheets of paper, and then the player will need to collect some guessing tokens in their player color as well. The number of guessing tokens depends on the player count. You'll take the number of tokens equal to the player count minus 1. So in our example, we're going to be showing a 4-player game, which means we would need 3 guessing tokens, A, B, and C. In a 6-player game, the players would need to take 5 guessing tokens, A through E. Then place the point tokens in each player's color next to the game board. They'll be used later in the game. Finally, return any unused components back to the box and pick a player randomly who will be the dealer in the first round. A game of Subtext is played over a set number of rounds. In each round, a different player will be the dealer. The number of rounds played will be different based on the player count. In games with smaller player counts, each player will be the dealer twice, and in larger player count games, each player will be the dealer once. Each round will consist of 2 phases, the drawing phase and the guessing phase. Let's look at the first phase, the drawing phase. At the start of the drawing phase, this round's dealer will draw the top card off of the deck of word cards. The dealer will memorize the word on the card that matches this game's number. At the start of the game, we selected the number 1, so every player in this game, including the dealer, will be drawing clues that relate to the first word on each of the word cards. Then, the dealer will draw cards into their hand until they have 1 less card than the player count. So in our example, the dealer already drew 1 card at the start of the round, so they would draw 2 more cards from the top of the deck. They now have 3 cards in hand, 1 less than their 4-player count. The dealer then shuffles all of these cards together and deals them out to the rest of the players. In our example, the green player was the dealer. So after completing the steps that we looked at previously, the green player dealt out these cards to the other players at the table. It's important to note that since the card that the dealer drew has been shuffled in with the other 2 cards, one other player besides the dealer has the same word as the dealer. So for instance, the dealer's word is guitar. One other player at the table will also have the clue of guitar. The player that has the same clue as the dealer is known as the partner. This will become important later in gameplay. After each other player has drawn their word card, they will then look at the word that relates to the number card, so in our game example, the number 1 word, and draw a picture that relates to that word. So for instance, this player needs to draw a clue that relates to a swimming pool. This player draws a clue that relates to the word poker, and the yellow player has the same word as the dealer. The yellow player is the partner in this round. Both the yellow and green player will try and draw a clue that relates to the word guitar. Each player will draw a picture that relates to the word on their card. It's important to note that no numbers, letters, or words can be used in the drawing. Once everyone has finished their drawings, the dealer will place their picture to the left of the board, while the other players will place their clues to the right side of the game board. Start at the top of the game board next to the letter A, and then continue towards the bottom. The next phase of each round is the guessing phase. Everyone, including the dealer, will look at all of the clues and try and determine which player drew a clue that matches the dealer's clue. So in our example, the dealer drew an axe to try and connect to the word guitar. So every player, including the dealer, will place one of their guessing tokens next to one of these pictures, and they're trying to guess which clue matches the dealer's clue. In our example, the yellow player drew a speaker to also indicate the clue guitar. It's up to all of the other players at the table to try and make this connection, including the dealer and the partner. And once again, since the dealer doesn't know the identity of the partner, they will take a guess during this phase as well. During our earlier discussion of the drawing phase, our guessing tokens were face up. But during the guessing phase, it's important that each player's guessing tokens are face down with the broken pencil side face up. Then, each player will secretly pick the letter that they think connects to the dealer's clue and place this letter guessing token in the middle of the table. When all players have placed their guessing tokens, turn them all face up, then the dealer will declare their word and the partner will point at their drawing. Any guessing tokens that show a different letter than the partner's drawing are wrong. Turn any wrong guesses face down, showing the broken pencil side. Players will then score points, and it's important to note that players will only score points if they guess correctly. It's also very important to note that the dealer and the partner only receive points if they both guessed correctly. So for instance, if this had been the case and the dealer guessed the wrong clue, then neither the dealer or the partner would score any points. But let's say, for example, that both the dealer and the partner had guessed correctly. If this happens, then both the dealer and the partner will gain 1 point for every wrong guess. So in our example, there's one wrong guess at the table, so both the dealer and the partner would gain 1 point. To indicate this, the green and yellow player would move their player markers onto the first space of the point track. Each player that is not the dealer or the partner receives 1 point for every wrong guess, plus one additional point. So in our example, there was one wrong guess, which means that the pink player would receive no points. But the blue player guessed correctly, which means they would receive 2 points. 1 point for the one incorrect guess, and then one additional point. To indicate this, the blue player would move to the 2 point space of the point track. And just to further clarify scoring, if every player guesses correctly, then the dealer and the partner receive no points, because there were no wrong guesses. Each other player would receive 1 point in this case. 0 points for incorrect guesses, but one additional point. And it's also important to note that if the dealer and the partner guess wrong, and all of the other players also guess wrong, no one would receive any points. At the end of the guessing phase, the players can discard the used cards and clear the table of any clues. Then, the next player in clockwise order becomes the dealer and a new round would begin. So, in our example, the pink player would be the next dealer. It's also important to quickly mention that players will track points by moving their player figures along the game board. If they're at 12 points and they would receive a 13th point, they would simply move their player token back to the 1 space and then take the 12 or 24 point marker in front of them to indicate that they have that many points already. The game will end after the set number of rounds. The player with the most points will win, and if there's a tie, the tied players share the victory. All right, everyone, thanks so much for watching. That was our video. We hope that it was helpful, and we hope that it was informative. If you have any other questions about how to play the game, please comment below or email us directly at thediceyreview@gmail.com. If you want to hear more from the Dicey Review, you can listen to the Dicey Review podcast. It can be found on iTunes, Stitcher, TuneIn, just about any podcasting app. You can read our written reviews at thediceyreview.com and make sure and connect with us on social media or at our Board Game Geek Guild. Thanks so much for watching, and until next time, we'll see you at the table.